I'll go back to the reference of the iceberg, what is beneath the surface of the water. The knowledge of how such images and sublime concepts can be presented in the second language in such a way as to be exact or almost exact to the original. And here, the knowledge of the translation of the translator comes in play. Because here the translator will create his or her adulterous beauty, or her or his ugly adulterer, as the other translator mentioned. But of course, in every translation, what plays a very important role is the personal knowledge of the translation, of the translator. Better, let me state it better like this. The knowledge the translator has of the original poet. The knowledge the translator has of the original poet is very important, because the better the knowledge of the original poet the translator has, the better the translation is at the end of the day. Very important for the translation also is to find the way to present the meant or hidden humor or workplace or phrases that exist only in the original language, and how he can reproduce those in the new language. We all know the difference in how, from one language, the difference how certain things are presented from one language to the other. We say, for instance, in Greek, the word chrimata, and we mean money. Money in English is a singular word in a singular instead of in a plural. In Greek, it's exactly the opposite. Money is in plural. If the translator has in his mind or his mode is in Greek, he may make a mistake when he wants to translate the word chrimata into English. He may say monies. But monies is accepted to a certain degree. It depends in what position in the sentence that word will sit, will be positioned. English is a positioning language. Words have to follow an exact format. They cannot go in disarray like it is in Greek. In Greek, the Greek is very free-flowing, allow me to use this term, free-flowing language. You can put a subject in a sentence and stands as good as a noun without a noun. You cannot say in English, for instance, the word, let me find it here in my notes. I'll find it.